Hey guys, this is Charles Jaeger with PremiumBeat.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the basics of how to use the new Content Aware Fill in After Effects. And this allows you to automatically remove unwanted objects in your footage. Alright guys, before we get started here, I do want to mention you can download this first clip that I'm going to be using with the project file. And that'll be available on the PremiumBeat blog if you want to go ahead and follow along. There'll be a link for that in the description of this video. So with the new Content Aware Fill in After Effects, we can easily remove objects like these cars here behind our main lead car on moving footage, and it's pretty astounding. So let me go ahead and just show you where you can find this new tool at and how we can get started with it. So first we need to come here to Window, and come down here, you're gonna see New Content Aware Fill. I'm gonna go ahead and click that. That's gonna open up the Content Aware Fill panel, which has quite a few options here, and we'll go through these as we get to them. Now the first thing we need to do is we actually need to mask out any objects we want to remove. And so let me go ahead and show you what I've went ahead and already done. So I'm just going to hit M on the keyboard, and we can see these masks that I've created here over these cars that are following the lead car. You can see I've got three masks. You'll notice they're pretty broad masks. It's nothing like real specific rotoscoping. I do have a few different keyframes down here for each of the masks. But again, nothing too intensive. And I've found that the results you get with the Content Aware Fill really work well on objects that are actually moving through your footage. So in our case with these cars, because we can see the road at different points in time where there isn't a vehicle over top of the road, that's really going to help Content Aware Fill to fill in those gaps. So enough talking about it, let's just go ahead and see this in action. So what I need to do on each of these masks is just go ahead and set that to be subtract. So now you can see as I toggle on the alpha channel here, we have gaps or holes in our footage. I'll go ahead and turn that back off. If we look over here on the Content Aware Fill, you can see a kind of a mini preview of where we can see objects we've removed from our footage. You can see as I scroll through this, it kind of updates. Now the first option we have is alpha expansion. And what this acts like is kind of like a mask expansion. If I go ahead and increase this, you'll see on that preview, those gaps in our footage get bigger. And you can experiment with this if you get varied results, but I'm just going to leave this on the default zero for the time being. Next, we have the fill method, and really this kind of looks at what you're wanting to remove. So in our case, we're wanting to remove these cars, which are objects. So I'm going to leave that on the default. We have two other options here, such as surface and edge blend. And I'll talk more about those in just a little bit. Next, we have range, and we can select from work area or the entire duration of your comp. Now in my case, the work area and the comp are both the same, so I'm just going to leave that on the default. Next, we have the option to create a reference frame, and I'm gonna cover that in just a little bit. So now we can go ahead and click Generate Fill Layer to go ahead and fill in these gaps. So when I select that, we're gonna see it's gonna analyze the footage. And this is a 5-second clip, and you can see it's going pretty quickly. And once that finishes, it's gonna go ahead and render out a PNG sequence and import that automatically into our composition. All right, looks like it has completed. Let's go ahead and RAM preview this and see what the results look like. All right, so now we can see our lead car driving through, and it appears that all three of the other vehicles have been removed pretty seamlessly. And it's pretty crazy to think about that because we are actually on a moving shot with the drone here, and then we have other objects moving throughout the scene, and they've all been removed. We can see where the masks are there, where the cars used to be. So let's come over here and see what's actually going on. So you can see we have this PNG image sequence that's been added to our composition. If I go ahead and check this on and off, you can see really what this is. Let me go ahead and solo this too so you can see where it's filled in those gaps where the vehicles were before. And it's using a pixel aware algorithm to basically fill in those gaps, looking at pixels throughout the footage and replacing them and tracking them where those gaps were. So let me go ahead and unsolo that. And for this PNG sequence, if we navigate up here to the project panel, you'll see we have a new folder called fills. If I toggle this down, we'll see the name of our composition. And then within this, we will see that PNG sequence, and it renders out that PNG sequence to your hard drive, wherever your After Effects project file has been saved. Now, if we navigate back over here to the fill method, as I mentioned, the object is probably gonna be the fill method you're gonna use the most. And again, that's good for removing objects that are moving throughout your scene. Some of the others we have here are surface, and that's really good for removing things like stickers or flat logos. An example would be like a logo on the back of a laptop screen. And next we have edge blend, and that's a really fast method. It's gonna kind of blur around the edges of whatever you've masked out. And that's really useful for simple flat surfaces like paper, or maybe if you have a few blemishes on a flat colored surface. All right, so let's take a look at another shot here, one we can use the create reference frame option on. And what I've got here is a drone shot, and you can see we have this cell phone tower right here. And let's say I wanna go ahead and remove that because it's a little bit distracting for this shot. Now the first thing we'll notice is that the cell tower is obviously static, compared to the vehicles that were in our previous shot. So the cell tower isn't really moving throughout our scene. And in a case with something like this, creating a reference frame is gonna be very valuable. So let me just come down here to my footage. I'm gonna hit M on the keyboard for mask. And you can see I've created a very simple mask around the cell tower. I'll just zoom in here so you can see that. And I've done this with only two keyframes. So I'm just gonna set this to be subtract. So we've subtracted the cell tower from that. So now I can go ahead and create a reference frame. So I'm just gonna select that. And that's gonna automatically launch Photoshop and import that frame into Photoshop. So from here, we can use the clone stamp tool to cover this area up and then import that back into After Effects. That's gonna give the content aware fill a better idea of what we want to replace that cell tower with. So I'm just gonna select the clone stamp tool. And I'm gonna adjust my brush size here just a little bit. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit closer to this. So I'm just gonna select Alt over here to select some of these trees. That's gonna be Option on a Mac. And I'm just gonna kind of paint out this area where the cell tower was. And I'm gonna select a little bit smaller brush here for these buildings and zoom in just a little bit closer. All right, so that was a really quick and easy removal of that cell tower. So now what we can do is just come up here and go to File and then Save. And then once that's saved, I'm just gonna close this out. Let's go ahead and navigate back to After Effects. All right, so back in After Effects, we'll see it's already imported in that reference frame. You'll notice that's below our actual footage here with the mask. And again, because that's just gonna be a reference frame to give content aware fill a better idea of what we want to fill in those gaps with. So let's go ahead and select Generate Fill Layer. And this is gonna go ahead and analyze and then render out that new PNG sequence. I'm gonna speed this up to when that finishes. All right, guys, now we can go ahead and see the final results from that. And you can see it has removed the cell phone tower pretty effectively. Now for the sake of transparency, I did have to create another reference frame right here at the end of the footage. And you can actually create those all throughout your video if you're getting results that aren't completely what you're looking for. But I found with both of those, it gives me a pretty good result here. Now if we zoom in and really pixel peep this, we will see a little bit of smearing, kind of where that pixel replacement is occurring. But if we zoom out and actually look at the full scope of the final shot, you'll see that removal is very convincing, especially for how quick and effective that was. Alright guys, hopefully you enjoyed this getting started tutorial with the new content aware fill in After Effects. Again, make sure you download the project file footage if you want to go ahead and try this out yourself. That's going to be available on the Premium Beat blog. While you're there, check out all the other tutorials we have over there as well. This has been Charles Jaeger with Premium Beat. Thanks for watching.